Little while earlier, I spoke to Arun Jaitley. Mr. Jaitley, first question, are you trying to precipitate things politically very quickly on the first day of parliament by asking for voting motion under 184 on corruption and price rise, both?
Well, numbers game is important in a democracy.
Yes.
There is nothing sacrosanct or only merely debating and reducing parliament to a talking forum without seeing the sense of the house. Therefore, on some issues, not all, there will be a numbers game and motions will have to be voted upon. How is it scandalous or improper in any way for an opposition to say, well, let's take the sense of a house on these issues? It happens in all democracies.
No, I've neither said it is scandalous, nor have I said, Mr. Jaitley, that it is improper. The question is, the BJP suggested the Prime Minister personally polarized the situation with his comment on Sunday. You did say that, and Sushma Swaraj also said that.
He indeed did. He indeed did. His Parliamentary Affairs Minister, his Finance Minister have been in active consultations with the BJP leadership in Parliament. How the session can function, time to be allotted for government business, time to be allotted for opposition concerns. While all this is going on, you suddenly have a provocative statement which says, I will expose the scandals in the or the skeletons in the opposition cupboard. Well, there are serious questions, particularly on 2G, with changing stand by the day, that the Prime Minister's office has to answer. Now, instead of answering those issues, you can't deflect them and say, I'll take the battle to the opposition's camp and start accusing you in place.
No, they're also talking of taking the battle into the opposition camp by saying, and top UPA ministers have said that, and instead of targeting certain names and scams, you, that is the opposition, should be bringing in if you want a motion of no confidence against the government.
Well, I thank the government for advising us, but the opposition strategy has to be decided by us. And the opposition strategy very clearly is that we want to highlight the entire issue. If at some stage a need arises, we'll do that. But that certainly will not be on the advice of the government spokesperson.
Well, obviously, it's some thinking with which you have come to the conclusion that price rise is the issue on which you can get the numbers together. Does the BJP expect parties like the SP and the BSP to vote against the government on the price rise issue? Because if they do, then the numbers on both sides become much closer than they are right now, Mr. Jaitley.
There are two different kinds of chemistries in a democracy. One relates only to the parliamentary numbers. Those who indulge in cash for votes always feel confident of manipulating parliamentary figure. But the real chemistry is which way is the public opinion swinging on these issues. And I think that's extremely important.
No, but is it purely political, the way you're responding to it? Because we've had the government say, Pranab Mukherjee in fact said yesterday, that price rise is a function of a host of factors, including global factors and the slow pace of the recovery of the American economy. All of these factors also contribute. Whereas you may be looking at it purely politically, Mr. Jaitley.
I am not for a moment disregarding any factor, but I am certainly concerned with the fact that you have a bumper harvest in the country. At the same time, you have skyrocketing food prices. Now, this is a situation.
My reference is to global factors.
Domestic in nature. The management of the food economy and the only methodologies this government has learned how to contain prices is not to concentrate on the supply side, but merely hype up the interest rates, which are going to significantly affect growth. And when growth gets affected, everything else suffers.
Now, look at the method that you're following. I also spoke to JPC chairperson, Mr. P.C. Chacko, and he also told us, and everyone's been saying it, you're a preeminent lawyer yourself, Mr. Jaitley, that by raising 2G, a matter which has actively been reported in all the newspapers every morning because it is inevitably a matter which is being raised in the courts, you're getting into issues that are sub judice. That's the government's argument.
Well, that is the last resort of any person who has a sense of guilt about them. Sub judice rule never applies to matters of public importance. Ayodhya is sub judice for the last 100 years, but that doesn't mean that it can't be discussed in parliament. Every time Article 356 is imposed or misused, it is sub judice in a court, you still discuss it in parliament. Bofors was sub judice, it was always discussed in parliament. Similarly, what is sub judice is only the culpability of those who've been arrested. The policy domain is not something which is sub judice, and therefore let the government not resort to these technicalities.
You have
sub judice does not apply to policy domain and improper implementation of policy. It only relates to individual culpability.
Let me draw you back on what you've said about the Prime Minister, and you said he's vitiated the atmosphere. Mr. Jaitley, would you and Sushma Swaraj have not have moved for voting motion under 184 had the Prime Minister not made those comments? Would you have pulled back?
No, we were already in the process of discussing with the government, as I said, and as Sushmaji also pointed out, the finance minister, the parliamentary have already discussed with us,
so then,
which are the subject of opposition's concern, which will be discussed, whether there will be a consensus resolution or there will be an adversarial resolution. These were all subjects which were being discussed, and that's what we've said so today in the press conference, and we've disclosed the people who met us.
So you've been trying to indicate that the Prime Minister and the Congress Party's political managers in Parliament are not speaking the same language, that they are not on the same line.
Well, that's the freedom, that the freedom which you have, but I think it's ex facie clear that the Prime Minister's statement and what his other cabinet colleagues are doing, there seems to be a little disharmony between that.
But if there has to be a numbers game, and it seems to be moving towards a numbers game, it has to be a serious numbers game. And it will eventually come down to numbers. Let me draw you back. Where are you going to get those additional numbers from? It's only then that the situation in Parliament will really get polarized, and you'll have, you know, both sides racing towards the numbers, or is that a foregone conclusion that you will lose and they will win?
Well, I don't think we are taking, as I clarified it to you and I reiterate that, parliamentary numbers is not the issue at the moment. At some stage it could be. Today we are looking at a larger chemistry. How does the Indian voter and the Indian people, how do they react to what's going on?
No, so is this all purely symbolic? Because you're also asking for a vote in the Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha vote does not bring down government. So is it only aimed at political embarrassment?
Well, is a vote in any House of Parliament irrelevant or redundant in a democracy?
No, not irrelevant.
Parliament is supposed to vote upon issues. The Parliament is not supposed to merely discuss and talk out an issue.
No, not irrelevant. I am only talking about the pure symbolism. So is the purpose to raise the index of opposition unity on the first day of the monsoon session?
The purpose also is to convince this government that the country, as also the Indian opposition and Indian parliament, is deeply concerned about the failures of this government.
If consider this, Mr. Jaitley, if the Prime Minister will come and clarify on the comments that have obviously upset you and Sushma Swaraj and the BJP, will the standoff end?
Well, I don't know. I can't comment on hypothetical situation. It's for the government to decide what strategy they adopt next.
Thank you very much, Mr. Jaitley. Thank you very much indeed.